floor. You're going to run around the cushion, just like this. Yeah? Keep facing the same direction, using your arms. Let's go. Good. Keep going. And change direction now. Change direction. Keep it going. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Now keep running to the side of your cushion. Rasha, go. Just hop over it. If you want to do a tuck jump, you can do a tuck jump over it if you prefer. We're just getting warm though, so remember, keep that in mind. Ready? Go. And sprint in. Go. That's it, Lauren. Go. That's Kate. Lift their knees up high. Go. 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 Keep running it out. And go. Excellent. Pick up your cushion. Next one. I'll show you from the side. Reach it up. Tap your chest. Push the floor. Tap your chest. Reach up. Let's go. Keeping that back straight. Keep it going. You've got 30 seconds here. Keep it going. 10. That's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Now we need cushion on the floor. Hands either side. Bring your chest to the cushion. Every time, your best push-ups. You've got 30 seconds. Keep your head in front of your hands. Go!
Straight up. Level 2, go up.
last 8 seconds of warm up. Are you ready? Give me a thumbs up if you're ready. Go! Be masking. Last 8 seconds.
Throwing a lot of overkicks
punch it, and then you're able to get out of the way of the leg kicks much easier. Having this front foot slightly off at this angle allows you to check the kicks easier. Yeah? I never really use this one. It's more of a Thai style guard. I'm going to start experimenting with it, with this foot slightly out to the side. Okay, like 1 o'clock, 1, 2 o'clock maximum. So, in you guard, hands up, chin down. Keep your chin down. This is so important here. Having that chin down is really what protects you. Look how hard I'm going to be able to, look how hard it is for somebody else to hit me if I'm stuck like this. I chin it down, my hands are up, and I'm protected with that shoulder. Okay? For that left jab, ready? 1, 2. Good. Step forward and you punch that left arm. 3. Then get back out. 4. Good. 5. Excellent. Further cross now. Turn and lift that back heel up. 1, 2, 3. Excellent. That's your other. 4, 5. Good. Put together. Jab cross. 1, 2, 3, 4. Be fast and sharp. 5. That's it. Great Vinny. This time, left arm hook. Left arm hook. 1, 2. Retain on that front foot. 3, 4. Elbow, wrist, and shoulder in line. 5. Good. Now go cross hook. Cross hook. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. Good. Excellent. Now left arm uppercut. Left arm uppercut. Bring your elbow into your belly button. Use your legs. Get underneath them. 1, 2. Keep your right arm on your chin. 3, 4, 5. Add the cross on the end. Uppercut then cross. 1, 2, 3. I might even step forward on that open door. 4, 5. Excellent. Right arm open door. 1. Elbow in. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now go open door, both cross. 3 punches. Go. Open door, cross. Good. As soon as you feel that cross, bring it back to your cheek. Cross back to your cheek. Yeah? Go. Yes, that's better. Go. Go. One more time. Go. Excellent. Now go. Jab, cross, hook, cross. Jab, cross, hook, cross. You've got 1 minute. Jab, cross, hook, cross. Yeah? Go. Left, right, left, right. That's it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Put my hand on your cheek, every punch. Drive that cross in with lifting that back heel. Turn your foot and lift your heel. Hands. back straight. Ready? Four, three, two, one. Up. Four, three, two, one. Two, four, three, two, one. That's three. Keep going. Four, three, two, one. That's four. Come on. Push up strong. Two, one. Push. That's five. Four, three, two, one. Up. Six. Four, three, two, one, push up. Seven, four, three, two, one, push up. Eight, four, three, two, one, push up. Nine, one more time. Four, three, two, one, push up. Ten. Excellent, stand up. You feel that? Excellent, got up. Now you go. Jab, cross, up, up, cross. Jab, cross, uppercut, cross. Four punches, ready? 30 seconds, go. Left, right, jab, cross, uppercut, cross. Left, right, left, right. Left, right, left, right. Left, right, left, right. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Step in, that's it, Vinny. Step forward. Do your pushes and get back out. Switch dance, go. Right, left. Keep your chin down, other hand on your cheek. Chin down, team. Keep it going. Good effort, keep going. That's it, Lauren. Excellent. Bring those shoulders forward a little bit so you're protected. Last five. Four. That's it. Three. Two. One. Push up round two. Come on. Only 10 push-ups. Count down to four. Ready? Four. Three. Two. One. Push up. Four. Three. Two. Push up. Four, three, two, push up. Four, three, two, push up. That's four. Four, three, two, push up. Five, four, three, two, one, six. Four, three, two, one, seven. Keep going. Four, three, two, one, eight. Four, three, two, one, nine. Four, three, two, one, ten. Excellent. Stand back up. Excellent. Well done. Next, parry. Parry and punch. Left arm parry first. This is a straight punch. Coming out of your face. You just deflect it away. Deflect it away. It's coming straight at you. And you're just tapping it away. It's not a big movement. It's that you're open to get hit. You're just knocking it away. Just deflecting it away. Ready, left hand, one, two, that's it, hand open and strong, three, four, five, add a cross at the end, one, and you want to count up quick, one, two, parry across, three, four, five, right hand parry, one, two, three, four, five, easy, add the jab, one, leg is strong in this position. It's straight. And it's good like that. I'm tucking underneath the punch and then hitting the body. Like a lunge. Ready? One. Left block, right punch. Two. Three. Four. Five. Excellent. You've got 10 straight punches forward. 10. Rotate to your right. Keep rotating until you've done 50 punches all in total. 10 forwards, 10 to the side, back side, 10 more forwards. 50 all together. Go!
Side, knee.
Last time with me, go. Sorry, front, round, side, knee. 30 seconds, keep practicing that, go. Front, round, side, knee. We'll have three sliders between. One, two, three, go again. Kick, 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 knee. One, two, three. Front, round, full position, knee, and back. And you got it. Front, round, side, knee. One, two, three, and high. Switch stance. Is that the same as the stance now? Do it with me. Front, round. Yes, this balancing foot. To begin with, you can step your foot out of the side, 45, and then pulling it. When you get more used to that, more advanced, you just take your heel off, and you twist on it, and then twist back. The momentum of you bending your leg back in and pulling it back with your hip flex pulling back there turns your foot back. Yeah? Ready? Front. Round. Body sideways. Side. Knee. Good. And again. Front. Round. Side. Knee. Good. Remember to lean back when you feel that knee. Last time with me, go. Front, round, side, knee. Good, 30 seconds, go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Good, keep going, team, you're doing great.
Right knee back to your guard.
Good. Good. Flinch. Flinch, bring it back. One more time. Come on. Hook. Knee. Bring it back. Last combo. Combo three. Good kick. Straight into your jab cross. Again, twist those shoulders through. Turn that back heel. Turn the foot, lift the heel. One more time. Front kick. Drop straight into your push punch. Actually, one more. You got it. Front kick. One, two. Excellent. So when your left arm's punching, your right arm's on your cheek. And when your right arm's punching, your left arm's on your cheek. Yeah, all the way around. Okay, white belts, you go ahead and practice. You can either practice combo one, combo two, combo three, then switch stance and learn the other stance. Or you can do combo one 3 times, combo two 3 times, do each one 3 times, then switch. You got it? No. Yellow and orange belts. Combo, I'll do a review just to remind you of the 3 different combinations of this time. Combo one looks like this. Bring it back. Yeah, do that with me. Step in. Jab. Uppercut. Hook. Ground kick. And back. Look how much I protect myself all the time. Yeah, again. Jab. Uppercut. Hook. Ground kick. Bring it back. One more time. Jab. Uppercut. Hook. Ground kick. Bring it back. Excellent. Keep out the hand in your cheek. Combo two. Combo two, lean back, ground kick, open ground kick. As soon as you drop that kick, cross, slip, cross. Bubble weave to the right, and again. Ground kick, cross, slip, cross, hands on your cheeks. Just underneath the bubble weave. One last time, ground kick, cross, slip, cross, hands on your cheeks, bubble weave. Combo three, step in. Jab, oh sorry, jab, cross, hook, uppercut. Switch knee, land in front, good. Again, step forward, jab, cross, hook, uppercut. Switch your feet, knee and land in front. Yeah, you're going to get all that power on that switch, knee, land into your guard. Practice all 3 combinations now, let's go. How the wind bone stances, so combo one, go. Jab, uppercut, hook, ground kick, bring it back. Combo two. Mountain, cross, slip, cross, bubble weave. Yes, Neil, well done. Smooth without bubble weave at the slips. Combo three. Jab, cross, hook, uppercut, switch, knee. Yeah, Ethan, we'll go back to combo one now. Ready? Hands up. Back to combo one. Jab, uppercut, hook, ground kick. Good. Combo two. Ground kick. Cross, slip, cross. Hands up, bubble weave. Combo three. Jab, cross, hook, uppercut. Switch, knee. If you're not already, switch stance. I've learned those stances. Jab, uppercut, hook. Ground kick, bring it back. And number two. Ground kick. Cross, slip, cross. Bubble weave. Nice. And then three. Step in, step forward. Jab, cross, hook, uppercut. Switch knee. Good. And again, I'll show you from the side. Combo one, step in, jab. Uppercut, hook. Ground kick, bring it back. Combo two, keep going, Vinny, you can do it. Combo two, lean leg, ground kick. Cross it, cross, combo wings. Combo three, step forward, jab, cross, hook, uppercut. Switch knee, finish knee up. Keep going, team. Final minute. I'm going to give you some feedback now. Keep working on it. Side. throw your right arm punch. Left round kick. You do your left round kick first, left leg. Left leg round kick, right cross, right hand. Yeah, right hand cross, slip, cross, left leg over here, okay?
Thank you.
squat. You can get on normal squats here, or squat, then jump. Go. That's it. Push up your toes. Right down the squat. Your feet can be out at a slight angle. Well done, mate. Keep going. That's it. Go right. That's it, Tab. Keep going. Go, mate. 3, 2, 1. Time. Well done. Pick it up. Take some deep breaths. Take some deep breaths. Okay. There's a fighter called GSP. There's a fighter called George St. Pierre. He gives away if you've heard of him. If you've not, have a look at him on YouTube. George St. Pierre. He's just been put in the Hall of Fame of the UFC. He's, the reason why I like him, he's very traditional and got a lot of respect. He's very humble and traditional martial artist. And he uses a Superman jab when he fights. A Superman jab. So we've got a Superman cross with the back knee up. He throws a Superman jab with his front knee up. Like that. So have a go with me. Pick up your left knee. Kick your left leg back and punch your left arm. And you keep your right hand in your cheek. Good again. Left knee up, left leg back, left arm punches. I'll show you from the side, left knee up, left leg back, left arm punches. Once you've kicked it, that leg back, put it back in front. Yeah? So you go knee up, and then land it in front, and then step it again if you want. So, left knee up, hop, kick back and step. So have a go at the left stance. Left knee up, hop, and Superman jab. Left knee up, hop. Doesn't need to be a high hop, you don't need to leave the floor too high. Just a little hop. Gives you that extra power, because you're driving that hip forward when you throw that cross. I'm going to the right stance now. Right leg in front, right knee up, right leg kicks back with your hop and push. Right knee up, hop and punch and land that point in front. Like you're pointing front once you kick. That's it, Tash. Go low. So right knee up, hop and punch. It's a little bit more advanced. Go low. Right knee up, hop and punch. Right knee up, hop and punch. Shadow boxing, go! You might put that in there. Maybe throw your combinations. Throw your combos. I did your slips and your bubble knees. Maybe leg check, front kick. Fire out those combos. Different combinations. Keep lying on your feet. Keep moving. That sparring combo. Cross sword body cross. You might throw that jab or put a little shot. Keep going. Go, Billy. Last push, hear that? You got last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and time. Well done, take your gloves off, come to the side. Okay. squat kick. Squat kick. As many as you can in 30 seconds. Down in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Hips come back to your heels, reach forwards, forehead to the floor.
You might be knee bent here. And then step your feet out. Hold it for a second as you stretch your calf muscles. One side and then the other side. Slowly walk your feet up. And reach down to your toes.
Even if you just visualize yourself completing the grading,
feeling really proud of yourself, that you know you've done your best, that's all you can do, and you know, you're happy with what you've done. And that can help you relieve that anxiety as well behind grading or behind anything else. And also, you could visualize yourself performing those combinations. Like athletes do this all the time. They'll visualize themselves running that race. They'll visualize themselves doing that jump, or musicians. And your brain actually doesn't know the difference a lot of times between the visualization and the actual movement and the act of it. So it's a great way to practice, really, just by visualizing yourself doing it over and over again. I did that with a back somersault. I obviously needed to practice physically as well, but I needed to visualize myself doing it over and over again and landing it. Number four is stretching your body, improving that flexibility. I've been just completed a 21-day hip opening challenge, and it was 15 minutes of stretching each and every day before bed. And I really enjoyed it. I've become more flexible, and I'm going to continue that. I'm just going to keep it part of my routine now, 15 minutes of stretching. I have actually had one or two days off before I started again, but I am going to make that a habit because I feel like it will really help later on in life too. And then five, practice. Practice your combinations, practice your fitness test. All of those things will definitely help with grading. Even if you're not grading this time, not everybody grades and tests each time. It's about you progressing at your pace. You're on your own journey. It's no competition with anyone else. You're exactly where you need to be right now. So keep progressing, keep doing your best, and attending these classes, and I'm sure you'll reap the rewards as you go if you keep putting in that action and that time and effort, okay? So that's our team talk today. Well done, and keep preparing for grading. Just 2 weeks to go. You'll have all the info, and we will do a live Q&A if anybody's got any questions. Have you got any questions before we go?